time is it?
7:30 a.m.
Have you got a bar here?
No, sir.
Get off it, Mike! Get off it! That was the last of the drink, you bastard!
I bloody stole it! You're a policeman! You could get a pub opener this time in the morning, couldn't you, eh?
Larry.
Ah, welcome. Come in, gentlemen. Everyone's been dying to meet you. Oh, I always say that. Thank you. Lovely, aren't they? They're a pair, you know. Now then, don't tell me. You're the off-license explosion. Seems awfully unsafe, the off-license trade these days still. One man's meat is another man's poison. Life goes on, or rather it doesn't, thank God. Leg! Anyone? Just joking.
No, sir, the hotel death plunge.
Well, now, he's over here, mostly. Yes, they're awfully good fun, aren't they? Would you care to examine the body?
Is it a girl?
Well, now, it's funny you should say that.
It's Fatty. Where did you get to? We were in the middle of a game of cards.
Yeah, we got tired of waiting, so we looked at yours and you lost. You owe us 50 quid and your car key.
Wake up! Wake up! You owe us money!
Yeah, wake up!
I'm afraid he's dead.
Well, who's got his money then?
Yeah, did you find his credit cards? He promised his to us. Well, we won them in a card game, actually.
So where are they?
Well, that's a strange feature, because when he came in, he was wearing nothing but this.
That's our property!
Yeah, we rented it to him!
Gentlemen, please, show some respect.
Tell him that he owes us 100 quid!
Are you sure you haven't got a bar in this place?
Yes, sir.
What is that alcohol smell, then?
Embalming fluid.
Balmy fluid! Right. I'll have some of that, then. Aha!
Gentlemen, please, do you know who this body is?
Yes, it's Fatty!
And who is Fatty?
He is Fatty! Look, we don't know who he is. All we know is his name is Fatty and he was a client.
A client?
Yeah. I think he should be grateful. We showed him a bloody good
chance. Yes, we did, and he didn't even bloody pay.
What do you mean, didn't even bloody even pay?
Excuse me!
Looking for a good time? So are we. Dreamy time escorts.
That's us, matey!
Escorts Bastards!
Obviously don't understand. Every off-license round here is supplied through Mr. Lovebucket.
But this is my point. It makes for absolute financial suicide. All the other wholesalers supply at a third of the cost for bulk purchase, sale or return. Do you understand? A third of the cost. Go and tell that to your Mr. Lovebucket.
You have to buy your drink through Mr. Lovebucket, otherwise you'll go bust.
How can I go bust? It's sound economic sense.
Well, your shop might burn down.
Yeah. Bottles do break.
Put it down, will you? Look, this is the fifth time you've been round here, and I've told you every time that I don't want to buy anything from your Mr. Love Juice. But to show you there's no hard feelings, I'm prepared to order one crate of tonic water.
Tonic water, is it?
Yes, tonic water.
Tonic water, he says.
Oh, really? Tonic water? Did you say tonic water?
Yes, tonic water.
He said tonic water.
You say tonic water, do you?
Yes, Tonic water is what I say.
If it's tonic water you want, it's tonic water you'll get. Come on.
Heimi Henderson.
Living above an off-license, what could be better?
Living in one?
You're right. We must become a lot more friendly with Heimi Henderson.
What have we got here, then? Cheese sandwich and half an apple. Good Lord, you'd think you'd have a drink with this lunch.
Get out of the way! Get out of the way!
Morning, Mr. Jolly.
Morning.
Good.
Large one.
Don't mind if I do.
Well, that's Fatty's money out of the window.
And Fatty.
Well, it's his own fault. You shouldn't play Let's See Who Can Fall Out of the Window the best when you're drunk.
Not on the 18th floor, no.
No. Running a bit low on alcohol?
Yes.
How's that stuff we started yesterday?
Well, it should be finished by now.
Well, let's have a look at that then.
Okay.
Ow. Bloody table. Well, that's a bit flat.
Wait just one moment.
That's very good. I'll have another. Quick! Brilliant. Get some gin! It's incredibly sparkling tonic water. Well, we're all out for tonic water then, aren't we? We're having a bloody tonic water party! Open the bloody window.
Pardon?
Open the bloody window!
Open the bloody window!
Fingers!
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 Fingers.
What was that for?
That's for a bloody tonic water.
I thought you'd drop me in a bucket for that tonic.
Don't be clever all the time. And come away from the window. Now listen. Quick, quick! Come in! Hello!
Hello!
Business is a bit slack. Hang on. Oh, morning, Ralph. How's the fluffy toy business?
Who the bloody hell are you? What fluffy? Oh, brilliant. Yeah. Now, are you sure nobody knows where you are?
Yeah, but for so long.
Yes, of course it was.
Shut up! Come in. Come in.
Now, are you sure absolutely nobody knows where you are?
Nine.
Right.
Did you hear that?
Yes!
Well, the bell's working then. I think I see old Jolly's got off to an early start. It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. When I see you hanging about with anyone, it's not unusual. All I'm saying is that one advertisement in the Times saying, "What are you doing this weekend? Fancy getting drunk?" won't work. You gotta put the telephone number.
But we know the telephone number.
Escorts, mascots, come in if you're saucy.
Can I borrow some fairy liquid?
What? Again? Shut up. Of course you can, Ralphie. Ooh, you're right, Ralph, if you cut yourself shaving.
I'll bring it back.
He gets through a lot of fairy liquid, doesn't he? Maybe his lager's flat.
Why must you always be so rude to Mr. Jolly? You are jeopardising our relationship with him.
I'm what?
I said you're jeopardising our relationship with Mr. Jolly. Then stop squeaking. Telephone.
Dreamy time, escorts!
What was that?
Wrong number. Only joking. It's an engagement for this morning, 10 o'clock. A Mr. Yakimoto.
Oh, God! Another French bastard!
Yes! He's at the Holiday Inn for a conference and wants two young, attractive, lithe escorts for a really good time. Should be a doddle. Ah.
Well, things are looking up.
this Yakimoto fella?
I didn't well.
This way.
Okie dokie.
Dreamy time, Escorts! No job too big, door to door. We are on the phone. Dreamy time, Escorts, monsieur!
Do you want to go to the toilet now?
You mind if I use your telephone?
Come on, let's make it messy!
Get me room service.
Come on, let's dance.
Room service, get me 8 gins. Now, I better make that 16 large ones.
Who dares gins?
Hang on, I'll find out. What's the room number?
Nibushi Shanghong.
Nibushi Shanghong. Okay. Bloody room service, you can never get a drink when you want. Bastards.
Saijan, Saijan, Saijan.
Oh, shut up.
You want a drink? Drinky?
Drinky.
Oh, cha, cha, yam cha.
What a remarkably wise choice, sir. That'll be £4.80.
Cha.
Well, that's very kind. Yes, I'll have one myself, yes. £9.60. You got a wallet, have you?
Nimen, buho, buho.
Well, that's very kind. We'll call it 20.
Buho,
thank you very
buho.
Much. What a nice man.
Off we go.
Off we go.
Elephant and castle, stick it up your arsehole.
Famous number 10 Downing Street. And look, there goes Winston Churchill on his way to buy some cigars. And they're open. Now this is what we call an old English pub. And oh look, here comes Dick Thorpe.
Good morning, Unstickerman.
Right, I'll have a large gin.
It's thirsty work, this highway.
Come along. And here we are inside the traditional English pub. Two large gins, please, landlord. Another old English pub.
Cheers.
And another old English pub.
Another old English pub.
That's right, mate. Bottoms up. Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah, this is another traditional old English pub, which is very close to closing time, if you don't mind.
Right, I've told you 4 times already. We're closed. You two out now.
Look, Buster!
Brenda?
And stay out!
Oh, look! A traditional old English illegal drinking establishment!
Squaw!
Over here. I think you're gonna like it here, mate. We're regulars, you know. Hey, Monica! Get home all right the other morning.
What are you talking about? What do you want?
Well, I think we'll indulge in 2 massive gins, please, Monica. Nothing for the French geezer. Sorry, mate, you have to be a member. Well, I think we're gonna have a very nice time here.
I think we are.
Come on.
You know Mr. Jolly, don't you?
Know him? He borrows our fairy liquid.
Yes, we live next door to him, actually, don't we?
Do you know who's coming in today?
He was doing a spot of cleaning.
Get this to him, please, and say that someone left it for him, said there was a drink in it for the person that delivered it.
Oh, let's open it up, then.
Drink on the house, stupid.
Yeah, drink on the house, stupid.
Right, so you're just coming for that one, then. Have you got the money this time?
Oh, of course, Monica. Wallet, monsieur. I wonder if we could organise some sort of drink now, pay later scheme. Molly, why don't you plop, plop.
Come on. Out! Out! Out!
What's Mr. Jolly got that we haven't got?
Our bloody fairy liquid! Ah, oh, dear.
Shut up!
Years.
It's your round.
Hooray! How much money have we got left?
I'll have a look. We have got £4 and a note for Mr. Jolly.
Oh, what does it say? It
says, take out this.
It's upside down.
Well, it's bloody useless then, isn't it?
Dear Mr. Jolly, here's £3,000. Take out Nicholas Parsons. Tonight. BBC TV Centre, 6 o'clock.
Mr. Jolly's going to be pretty annoyed when we give him the note and £8.
Nicholas Parsons? Why does Mr. Jolly get all the best jobs?
What are we going to say to Mr. Jolly?
Nicholas Parsons!
Yeah, we're going to say Nicholas Parsons! It's not going to get us very far, is it? We've drunk all his money. What are we going to do?
Don't tell him.
What about Nicholas? He's expecting someone to take him out. He's probably tired and sweaty after a long day in the studio, waiting somewhere fruitlessly.
Poor Nicholas. Well, we must do it.
Of course.
Escorts? Best courts.
It's a chance of a lifetime!
It's the pinnacle of escorting! Nicholas Parsons! Come on! Nicholas Parsons!
What about you?
Nicholas Parsons! Look out, police! Ah, good, officer, you found our van. It was stolen, you know. In fact, he stole it.
Yeah, he's
dead. Take it away. Are you drunk, sir?
Of course I am. I'm out of my bloody mind, I am. I just spent £3,000 in there.
It's all right, officer. He's not driving. I am.
Are you sure you're right to drive?
I told you it'd only take us 6.5 hours.
He's so handsome, isn't he? We'd like to spend an evening with Nicholas Parsons because we respect him. And we feel sure that he would respect us as loyal and devoted fans. To think they chose our entry out of the thousands and thousands of others. Oh, imagine, an evening for two in London with Nicholas Parsons. And to think it was only 14 years ago we were presented to Mr. Roy Castle, weren't we?
And it is 86 miles to the gallon.
No, they said we had to meet Nicholas outside BBC TV Centre at 6 o'clock.
Mind you, that's the beauty of a two-stroke engine.
You will get us there on time, my love. My little chauffeur.
Safest car in the world.
BBC, you old git!
That way, Gov, and turn left.
Right, thank you.
And have a nice day! Nicholas! Nicholas! It's us! We're here!
Oh, hello.
Looking for a good time, so are we! We've got the cash!
No, it's all right. The BBC are paying.
It is, isn't it?
What?
It's Nicholas Parsons.
Yes, I'm...
It's Nicholas bloody Parsons!
Yes,
look, everybody! It's Nicholas bloody Parsons! We're going to take out Nicholas Parsons!
Congratulations. My car's over there.
Now, Nicholas!
You get in here!
That's right! You drink, we drive! Right. Where do you want to go? Mad Kenny's all-night drinker?
Fatty Amal's kebab and off-license?
Or straight to the peep show?
Well, actually, I have reserved a table for three at the Dorchester.
The Dorchester?
Yes, the Dorchester.
The Dorchester with Nicholas bloody Parsons!
Brilliant!
Let's go!
And she said, well, I don't think you're a fishmonger. I think you've done a plop in the wrong lavatory. Ah! Oh, dear. So, Nicholas, I hear they're making Sail of the Century into a film.
Hey, well, Nicholas, look, I can line my...
But what exactly was your winning slogan?
Never, ever, bloody anything, ever.
And that was your winning slogan?
That's the one, Nicky. I've lived my life by that rule.
Hey, Nicholas, I wonder if I can light my burps. Mm.
I would like to spend an evening with Nicholas Parsons because never, ever, ever bloody anything ever.
You're pissed, aren't you, Nicholas?
Hey, Nicholas! I'm a fire extinguisher!
So, Nicholas, I suppose you spend most of your time opening supermarkets and heliports these days.
Well, yes, you know how it is, yes. As a matter of fact, tomorrow I am opening an off-license.
You're opening an off-license?
Yes, an off-license.
God! Imagine being so important you can open an off-license!
And we're with him right now, aren't we, Nicky baby?
Come on! Let's go and have a tattoo!
Yeah! One that says, I've been out with Nicholas Parsons!
You can have one that says, it's true! I was the bloke that took them out!
Yeah, we can worry about the spelling later!
And then we'll go back to your place and drink all your scotch! Well,
come on, let's go! Hey, get in the way, get in the way! Yes, 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 it's a fantastic house, Nicholas.
Oh,
now, have you got any dirty films?
No.
You bastard!
I said, no. Are you all right?
I know, Nicholas.
What? Yes?
Let's have some fun.
What kind of fun?
Let's play a game.
Not Fatty's game!
No, that's all right. Not Fatty's game. You're all right with us, Nicholas.
What is this game?
Well, these are the rules.
Yes.
I go out of the room.
Yes.
And then?
Yes.
I come back in.
Yes.
You got that?
Yes.
Right. I'll go first.
You're my agent. You've got to do something. Well, they're the strangest Mr. and Mrs. Cooper I've ever met. Are you sure they're not Terry Scott's winners?
Hey, Nicholas! Some of these bullets have got taps on!
I can't call the police. If they caught me here with these two, it'd ruin my reputation. I'm a family entertainer, remember? You've no idea what... Oh, my God, it's getting worse.
You want to watch those stairs, Nicholas?
Well, you've got to do something. They're breaking the place up. Yes.
Nicholas!
Yes?
This bottle is empty. Have you got one that's exactly the same but unopened?
I haven't got any more bottles.
Right. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Nicholas.
Oh, good night.
Good night, Nicholas.
Good night. And now, pissed from Norwich. Look, it's Nicholas Parsons.
Come, James, and don't spare the monkeys.
Where's the van?
can't eat this.
Is it too cold, Mr. Lovebucket?
I'm sure it's very tasty, but I just in a bad mood. Everyone for coffee?
Oh, yes, please, please, Mr. Lovebucket.
Right. Now then, Reg, Norman, Ron, Hilary. As you know, last week someone wrote on the back window of my car, Mr. Lovebucket is a wanker. Now, I don't understand this because I'm married. So not only is it very wrong, it's also very unkind. So I think whoever did this has to be made to regret it. Now, thanks to my contacts in the Metropolitan Police, I was able to get forensic analysis of the fingerprints involved. So I know who you are, and you know who you are. So why don't you step forward, Reg?
I'm sorry, Mr. Lovebucket.
I know you are. Nobody, but nobody lays a finger on my car.
They're leaving the house, Mr. Lovebucket.
What the bloody hell kind of driving did you call that? Show us your bloody license!
Where did you get your license? In a cracker!
Shut up! I had to fight you, already. That's it! That's it! We surrender!
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Which one of you is Mr. Jolly?
Eh?
Yesterday I paid you £3,000.
I am Mr. Or rather, he is Mr. Jolly. Mr. Jolly, there's someone to see you. I'm just Mr. Jolly's assistant. Could I have a name, please?
Quiet you.
It's Mr. Quiet you to see you, Mr. Jolly. It's a Hungarian, I think. I'll just go away.
Where's the body?
Under the head?
No, I mean Nicholas Parsons' body.
Under Nicholas Parsons' head?
Under the Parsons' nose, as it were.
Look, where is Nicholas Parsons' head, Nicholas Parsons' body, and Nicholas Parsons' nose?
Probably in bed. We had a bit of a rough night last night.
Look, did you or did you not take out Nicholas Parsons?
Yes.
You did?
Yeah, we took him to the Dorchester.
I know, but did you take him out?
Yeah, look, I've got the tattoo to prove it.
No, no, I meant take him right out.
Take him right out? What? Dorking?
No, no, I meant kill him.
Oh, kill him.
Kill him!
Now, if you don't kill Nicholas Parsons by 12 o'clock, I'll kill you. Make it tidy. If you can't do that, make it messy.
Yeah. And if you can't make it messy, make it noisy.
And if you can't make it noisy, make it stupid.
Stupid. Any questions?
I don't think so. How about you?
No.
Right then.
Do it!
Do it!
Do it!
Do it! Do it!
Do it!
Do it!
Do it!
Do it!
Thank you.
Morning, Nicholas. We're just leaving. Bye.
How long does it take Parsons to get from the breakfast table to the front door?
I don't know.
Right, I'll mime it. Yum, 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 yum. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter. Open the door. How long was that?
I don't know. I wasn't timing it.
Well, we'll call it 5 seconds.
Okay, it was 5 seconds.
And how long's the fuse on these things?
About 10 seconds.
Right. I'll count to five, and you stick these through the letterbox. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, through. Through. Push them out. Push them. Right, take them out. Put them in your pockets. Put them in your pockets and run over there. Run very quickly. Run, run, run. Off you go, off you go. Bye, bye, bye. Happy birthday. Now, this is the master plan. Parsons bends down to see what it is. And you smash his brain out with this. What do you think?
It's a scorcher.
Nicholas! Nicky, wicky, wicky, wicky! Sherry?
Darling, I've got to go. Just stay upstairs until I get back.
Wow!
They've let him go. Parsons off in a chopper.
The bastards. Let's get them.
Follow that helicopter!
The Jolly Brothers!
Sorry.
Mr. Henderson! Mr. Henderson! Mr. Henderson! Nicholas Parsons.
Fuck off.
I said Nicholas Parsons.
I know. Fuck off. I don't care if you're Bob Monkhouse. Fuck off.
Do you think I could use your telephone?
Do I have to spell it out? F U.
No, you have made that abundantly clear.
Anybody know you're here?
Apparently not.
Come on in.
Oh, thank you very much. I hope I'm not interrupting your
run. Old train, what I mean.
Right, made it. Get the suitcases. We're going to Rio.
But what are we going to do? We'll never find Nicholas Parsons before 12 o'clock.
I just told you, we're going to Rio. Now pack everything.
Yes, but what are we going to do?
We are going to bloody Rio!
What are we going to bloody do?
Shut up! Take it easy!
What are we going to bloody do?
Well, none of this would have happened if you killed Nicholas Parsons properly!
I don't seem to be able to get these damages in without smashing them!
Oh, God!
What's new, pussycat?
Maybe we have the meanest team, does it?
What's new?
We're looking for Mr. Jolly.
Are we talking fluffy toys?
We're talking a very fluffy toy.
Come on in, then. Excuse the mess. I had my godchildren round. It's all rascals.
Now then, where is Mr. Jolly?
I'm Mr. Jolly.
Eh? Let's get this straight. You're saying you are Mr. Jolly?
Of course I am. Now, what about this 3 grand?
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Now, what about the money?
He ain't Mr. Jolly.
I am Jolly.
You don't look very jolly.
Look, just because my second name is Jolly doesn't mean I have to be jolly all the fucking time.
Here, let a check out that office.
Parsons is coming here today.
But this is a dream come true. Come on.
Come on.
I know you're excited, but you'll just have to be patient.
Patience, my bottom. Hit him.
Come on! Matthias Rose, Hirondelle, Paul Masson, all the greats!
This is fantastic! All we have to do is hole up here, wait for Nicholas Parsons to arrive, and then kill him!
I beg your pardon?
Kill him!
If you're Mr. Jolly, where is Nicholas Parsons?
Oh, I just killed him.
You're a liar!
I have it your own way.
What is going on?
Oh, my God, I've just killed somebody.
Yes.
I mean, you've just killed somebody.
Did I?
Yes.
Bloody hell, I need a drink.
So do I.
What do you fancy? Gin and tonic?
That'll do nicely.
Thank you.